Brown County has roughly about 258,000 residents, and we are primarily an industry that was based on paper and agriculture. We also have a strong industry in our health services, along with manufacturing. We kind of, you know, in our, some of our strong, our long-term strategic planning, we kind of come down to the SSV is what we call it. It's sustainability, self-reliance, and value added. So when every time we look at something, what does this project do for sustainability? What does it move us towards self-reliance? And what type of value add does it add to the project? So in other words, anytime you're investing dollars, you want to make sure you have some type of result that will be a positive move forward. When we're looking at whether it's our port, our rail, our waste stream, the phosphorus, all these things have positive win-win outcomes that ultimately will ideally create an environment that makes Brown County, Northeast Wisconsin, a sought-after community for the future generation skilled workforce. In the bigger picture, of course, we're looking at what can we do as a as our part in the global perspective to ultimately address the changing environment, and how do we make sure that we can have the resources available for future generations.
Here, the enrollment of the Oneida of Wisconsin is just about 17,000 members. Approximately 6,200 live within the reservation boundaries. That varies. We base our philosophy to self-sustain, not only for ourselves present day, it's the seven generational mentality and the philosophy that many of the tribes across the country have always nurtured. You know, multi-generational thought process before we make a decision. How is it not only a reflection of those that have passed, but those that are coming? To make sure that the next generations have not only what we have, but improvements to what we have. We try to rely on what is around you naturally. You know, the evidence is there. The wind continues to blow, the sun continues to rise, you know. And to just capture those type of real natural energies that have always been there but have never really been focused on is something that we're working towards.
Prior to my arrival as the county executive, former county executive Tom Hintz worked with a number of other communities, primarily with the Oneida Tribe, to apply for a energy independent grant. And by having the 25 by 25 sustainability program, it really continues to have us discussing and communicating with our municipalities and our partnerships and the business community leaders. What can we do as a community to look at how we can engage in this discussion about appropriate investments for long-term sustainability?
The 25-25 Energy Independent Communities Grants, when we first heard about it, we were very interested in applying for ourselves because a lot of those principles were some of the same principles that we were trained to continue to improve on. So over the years, we've used a lot of renewable energy projects such as photovoltaic and energy, solar hot water heating. We've also even used solar heating. So we wanted to try to capture some of those things that we've been working on and bring it to that grant. And then Brown County came in and said, hey, we want to do the same thing. Is this something we can team up? So we were very supportive of them writing the grant, and then we would support information, share information back and forth, where we could, you know, basically learn from each other to actually begin to look at that process of conservation, efficiency, and then look at renewables. It actually worked out really nice over the years, kind of sharing information back and forth where we could take each other's idea and build on it for ourselves.
By being part of the Energy Independence Communities Grant, it's been a great opportunity for county departments to come together. We really hadn't ever had conversations like we had once we got the grant in regards to what we were doing. It really gave us a focus. We were able to go after some financial resources to enable us to do this. And many of the projects we've done have been very visible, whether it's relamping, building LEED certified buildings, you know, whatever it's been, you know, it's been very noticeable. And so that's been a super opportunity to help people understand that there's so much that each of us can do, but by working together, we can do a lot more. UW Extension's role within this project was to provide guidance in regards to delivering education. And particularly, we were looking at how do we educate the employees of Brown County, but also to create an action plan and deliver a common message about turning Brown County green.
My role in implementing the 25 by 25 plan is identifying and planning and implementing projects within the plan for the county, and that includes renewable energy as well as energy efficiency projects. Brown County takes a holistic approach to saving energy by having measured our facilities, our energy use, and the vehicles that the county owns. The county owns nearly 200 buildings and 400 vehicles. Brown County benchmarks facilities and opportunities for energy conservation with our usage and costs in our facilities, and primarily we do that by tracking our utility data with the Energy Star Portfolio Manager. Some of the projects that the county has done with regard to energy conservation has been with new buildings, having them LEED rated, so designed for sustainable design and construction and operation. The Energy Independence Plan grant helped the county bring the resources together to measure our facilities, our energy usage, and our buildings, and we did that back in 2009. And based on that work, we identified priorities and areas of focus, and with the granting of a energy conservation block grant from the federal government, we were able to roll out nearly $1 million worth of renewable energy and energy conservation projects. Civil Hop School is owned by Brown County.
The school is pretty much for cognitive disability children. They go here from 3 years to 21 years old. Therapeutic pool requires 88 degrees to 92 degrees. We're keeping it at 90 right now. We had no cover on it at all, so it was pretty much a cost, energy-wise, it was probably a lot to heat this pool.
This project cost the county $26,000, and it was funded from a windfall from a wind farm. We also received a $5,000 financial incentive from Focus on Energy. It's projected that this project will save in energy costs 60%, about $13,000 a year, and in water consumption about 66%, which would be just over 72,000 gallons per year. The payback period was less than a year for this project.
We started with a grant from the state of Wisconsin, and part of that grant was to do an energy audit of many of the buildings that the library owned. It used to be that the center area of the library where the skylight is was kind of the dark hole, and with the skylight, it suddenly became the bright core.
Well, at the Central Library, we retrofitted 708 two-lamp, four-foot fixtures. We went from 131 watts per fixture to 54. We're using less than half the energy, and we're getting about twice as much light. And our payback for this project was 8 days. We were actually paid back before the project was even half complete. So we paid for this project with the regular Focus on Energy incentives, the WPS enhanced incentives, and then we also applied the WPS pilot grant money.
We've seen our electrical bill go down. It's saved a lot and made our staff a great deal happier with light coming in.
With all of the energy efficiency projects we've done throughout the libraries, typically we've been about $100,000 under budget on our utility bill for many of the past five years.
The photovoltaic system at the Sheriff's Office consists of 8 fixed pole-mounted arrays, and it is a 22.5 kW system, and each year it's projected to produce 26,800 kWh. The cost of this project was $153,500 with our federal grant funding and funding from Focus on Energy and our local utility. The cost of the project was completely covered. Since commissioning this system 2 years ago, we've produced just over 65 megawatt hours of power, and it's saved the sheriff's office just under $7,200.
This building is a LEED Gold certified facility. Some very neat, unique and neat things that go into this building. In-floor heating that's run through geothermal. We have obviously daylighting, so we harvest as much daylight as we can in through this facility. We harvest rainwater off of half of this roof. Those waters are collected into a cistern which we use to clean and maintain our vehicles with. The airport is not what I'd call your typical department within the county. We are an enterprise fund. That means that this airport needs to generate all the dollars that it needs to operate. We needed to look at ways at cutting our cost. So when we think of LEED and we think of green buildings, the airport really looks towards that in a financial way. In any way that we can hold our cost or diminish our costs, we are looking to do that at every step.
The tribe has a number of departments, from facilities, Department of Public Works, engineering department, the environmental department, environmental resource board, or just a number of organizations within the tribe that recognize an energy challenge that the tribe was going to be experiencing in the coming years. Over the last few years then, we've been slowly developing plans. We've been successful at getting our hands on some Department of Energy grants to help with that planning process. One of the grants was the Energy Building Audit Program that was essentially used to do a building audits on a number of tribal buildings. They came up with a list of results as far as projects are concerned. I think 250 is the number of projects that are on that list, of which we want to prioritize and then be able to approach our business committee to help with budgeting issues and things like that. And this is going to be a 10-year program. So the Oneida Tribe has been doing some evaluation around fleet as well as mass transit ideas for community members and so forth. Again, it's an evaluation process. The Oneida Turtle School did receive a significant lighting upgrade as well. We've seen significant improvements in interior lighting. The tribe is involved with a number of community development projects. Anna John Nursing Home, this is Anna John Resident Center Care and Community. This is a solar thermal project that was partially funded by a number of sources, including the tribe. The load was calculated as such to require a 40-acre collector system to be able to provide more than 50% of the hot water requirements for the facility, and that equates to approximately $5,000 a year in savings as opposed to using natural gas.
The Oneida Tribe, we have an estimated 5,000 acres of rural forest land. We separate out the most valuable hardwoods and we use that for home heating assistance for our elders in the winter. We produce a lot of chips. We have a lot of waste wood that's not being recycled efficiently, so some of it's going to waste and beginning to rot. So we want to find some alternative uses, and we think energy. As we look to modify some of our conventional heating systems here into maybe some pellets or, you know, wood energy sources, and we can provide the feedstock for that.
About 3 years ago, we were able to partner with University of Wisconsin Green Bay to pursue a bioenergy crop project. The land is the tribe's greatest asset. The idea evolved to the point where we might be able to use energy crops established on farm fields or agricultural fields to be able to provide that same source. So we were able to work with UWGB to establish the energy crop. We have two fields established right now. We're just starting to see some good growth as far as switchgrass. There are stats out there that indicate that 1 to 2 acres of switchgrass is able to heat a home for a single heating season. As we continue to evaluate all of the technologies, we will be developing our portfolio and figuring out what is our best investment in the different technologies to help us achieve the kind of energy goals that we have.
The ability for us to move forward is to make sure that we're on the same page, and I believe we are there with Brown County because there's such a significant value in the minds of the leadership there to treat the earth, the environment, the way it's meant to be treated, better than it has in the past. That's all we can do as people. I think the best way for anybody, to really truly get an understanding of the efforts of any government, whether it's a tribal government or a local municipality, is to come and visit them. We're always here. We're not going anywhere, but we're always more than happy to show the efforts that we put forward, and as well as celebrate, some of the victories that we can collaborate together with the other counties, local municipalities, to show that we all are working hard to make things better.